Hey, what's up, practitioners? Grayson Carter here, and coming at you with part four of how to get more of your ideal clients from HealthProfs. So if you've been following along with the handful of videos that came before this one, chances are you're going to start getting more attention on your profile. You're going to get more people reaching out to you. Now, unfortunately, one of the biggest complaints that I hear about HealthProfs is that they get a lot of people, that the practitioners start getting a lot of people reaching out that are just kind of like tire kickers, aren't really that interested in becoming a client. They're just kind of feeling things out. And so they end up wasting a ton of time trying to respond to all these people that really are never going to end up becoming clients. So what we need is a way to be able to filter out those people that are serious and finding out, or a way that we can get rid of those people that, you know, really aren't all that serious about making a change to their health, so we can focus our time on the people that truly do want to make a change. So in part four today, I want to talk about changing up your phone number on your profile to not be your main phone number. So what I encourage you to do is, instead of having your main phone number on there that comes either to your cell phone or your office, is to set up a Google Voice number. And what that allows you to do is you can record a separate message on that voicemail. And so when somebody calls in, I recommend you have some sort of recording on there that goes like this. Hi, you've reached the office of Grayson Carter. If you're curious about working together, the first step is scheduling a free clarity call with us to chat and see if we're a good fit and to discuss potential treatment options. You can schedule the call online by going to graysoncarter.com/schedule. And for any other questions, please email us at support@graysoncarter.com. So what this does is, when somebody calls in looking for information, it tells them what the next step that they need to take is, and if they have other questions, to email you. And so you don't want to be answering the phone every time somebody calls you, because it's going to interrupt your day. It's not a good workflow, but you're still able to direct people to the next step to working with you. Now, to go one step further for this, and why I encourage this, is that when somebody goes to your scheduler, you should have a survey at the beginning of the schedule that you can find out more about that client before they can actually schedule with you. So I really like the program called Acuity, because that allows you to ask a handful of questions before somebody can schedule. And so what happens is, when somebody books onto your calendar, you have a handful of questions that you've been able to ask them to find out more about their situation. So what are they struggling with? What are they hoping to accomplish? Are you only interested in what insurance covers? If you're an insurance-based practice, you can ask what type of insurance they have. And so you can get a lot of those kind of preliminary questions out of the way first to decide, do I even want to get on the phone with this person? And if it's obvious based on their answers they're not somebody you can help or that you wouldn't be a good fit, you can politely reach out to them and respectfully decline the appointment, saying, hey, I don't think, you know, I'm the person to help you. Here's some other resources that I encourage you to check out. But at least this way, we have a process that we can take somebody from our HealthProfs profile to listening to a voicemail to directing them to the next step to schedule a call with us. Now, at any point along the way, if they don't follow the directions, they don't fill out the survey when they're scheduling with us properly, we're able to politely decline that call. And so we're not spending time with people that aren't all that serious about making a change. And so what that allows us to do is focus on the people that truly do want to make a change, and that likely would become a great client for us if we just paid a little attention to them. So we're freeing up our time, we're able to focus on the clients that we want to focus on, and also we're weeding out the tire kickers. So hopefully that is helpful. Let me know if you take advantage of this strategy, and hopefully this helps you free up some more time to focus on those ideal clients and get rid of those clients that really aren't going to be a good fit for you ever. So that's all for now. Thanks for watching.